Hello everyone, this is Dr. Garima Sachdeva and today we'll be discussing about the guideline on antenatal corticosteroids. So this is a green top guideline released in 2022 about antenatal corticosteroids. And today we'll be discussing that what are the steroids that we can give, what are the indications of giving it, how does it vary whether it's a normal delivery or a cesarean section, what are the problems with corticosteroids, what is the dose of the steroids that you give, what is the time period in which it is most effective, and about the is there any need to increase the dose or of steroids if it's multifetal gestation, role of rescue steroids. So all this we'll be discussing in this lecture. Hope you find it useful. So stay tuned. Okay, regarding steroids, antenatal corticosteroids. So before 34 plus 6 weeks, it's you have to give. Okay.
Before. Okay, 24 to 34 plus 6. We are offering.
Basically before 34 plus 6, you have to remember that you have to give.
Okay.
Now 35 to 36 plus 6, if it is normal delivery, then it is grade D recommendation. Like it is not the first thing, you have to explain the patient about short-term respiratory benefits associated with steroids, but simultaneously there is high risk of neonatal hypoglycemia. So risk benefit ratio has to, and it is grade D recommendation. So here you can offer, but it is not a recommendation, grade A recommendation. Less than 34 plus 6 you have to give.
Okay.
And 37 to 30, before 38 plus 6 weeks, if it is cesarean, then it is a grade B recommendation. Normal up to 34 plus 6 and for cesarean, up to 36. Okay. Right.
Beyond 37 or for all cesarean cases?
Even if it is, what they mean is before 38 plus 6 for any, this is what you remember, before 38 plus 6 for any cesarean you give, and for vaginal delivery the cutoff is 34 plus 6.
Yeah. Okay. For vaginal the cutoff is 34 plus 6.
Yeah. And cesarean?
Cesarean 38 plus 6.
Yeah. And you have to tell the patient that antenatal corticosteroids may reduce the admission to the neonatal unit, and it is uncertain if there is any reduction in the respiratory distress syndrome or transient tachypnea of the newborn or neonatal unit admission. Antenatal corticosteroid may result in harm to the neonate, which includes neonatal hypoglycemia and potential developmental delay. And what is the dosage when you have to give? First of all, you have to, it is most effective if it is given between 24 hours and 7 days.
Okay,
if the delivery takes place between 24 hours to 7 days of the last dose of the steroid, and dose is 24 milligram of dexamethasone in 2 divided doses, 12 milligram 24 hours apart or 6 milligram 12 hours apart.
Okay.
You can also give betamethasone or betamethasone, which is 24 milligram, which is 12 milligram, 24 hours apart, 2 doses.
But can we interchange the dose for both?
Dose is the same only, you know. For Dexa also, you can give 12 milligram.
Same only. Previously only it was different. Okay.
Betamethasone, there is no role of 6 milligram.
Okay.
Then regarding repeat or rescue dose, so as I told you that it is most effective between 24 hours to 7 days. Suppose the birth doesn't take place during this duration. So do you have to repeat? So there is very limited evidence that you have to repeat, but you should never give more than 3 doses. This is what is written in the guideline.
And what is the time period between 2 doses?
24 hours apart, no? 12 milligram, 24 hours.
For the second course?
1 week. So it is more effective only if...
Up to 7 days only. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Then twins and triplets, like do should we increase the dose? So no, it is not recommended to increase the dose. You have to give the same dose.
Okay.
Regarding diabetes, like steroids can increase the can worsen the diabetes and increase the chances of insulin higher doses of insulin requirement. But
Okay.
like in case it is required, you have to give, but you simultaneously admit the patient and monitor the blood glucose and increase insulin.
Okay.
Tell the patient about the risk of neonatal hypoglycemia.
Okay.
So this was about the guideline on antenatal corticosteroids. Thank you so much for watching.